afternoon, everybody. Thank you very much for inviting me. Shabunada actually invited us to come. Nothing much about myself. I started my career as a journalist. Those good old days when Statesman was considered a very serious paper, I started my career as a sub-editor and at the news desk, and then I moved on to the Telegraph and I started writing for features, and I was working for their foreign desk, and then I later moved to the edit department where, you know, we had to write edits, and I was writing on current affairs vis-a-vis the European Union, what I had studied at the postgraduate level in the UK. After Telegraph, I moved to Singapore Press Holdings in Singapore. Didn't stay there for more than a year because if you were not a Singapore citizen, you were not allowed to write. So all I was doing was editing. And that sort of bored me. And I came back. And I left journalism to pursue a career with Oxford Bookstores, where I headed marketing, PR, and the website nationally for Oxford Bookstores, because they were opening up stores in every city in India. Not every city, they were opening up stores. They opened up in Bombay, in Chennai, in Bangalore, in Goa. Calcutta, of course, was there. And it was a very exciting time for me and the team that I had across all these cities, because we were working with different publishers and launching works of eminent writers. I mean, we had a Salman Rushdie into the store. We had a V.S. Naipaul into the store in Calcutta. We had Amitabh Ghosh. We had numerous elite award-winning authors. Of course, Namanita Devsen, you know, the Grey Star store many times. She passed away recently. And upcoming writers. We also launched writers who were, you know, debut writers. We were launching their works as well. And we were also asked to build a brand for children. So every Sunday we have kids' activities across the stores where we encouraged reading in a fun way. So we, I did that for almost 6 years, and then I moved to Gurgaon where I started my career in entrepreneurship, and then I moved back to Calcutta. Journalism, Oxford Bookstores, Singapore, Gurgaon taught me a lot. I think I evolved as a professional and as a person. And we started, Shushruto, my partner, and I started Ahava Communications in 2012. We are an entity currently based in Calcutta. We do diverse work. We are into book launches. We've done about 28 book launches so far in Ahava. We work very closely with the Kolkata Literature Festival, which is organized by the Publishers and Booksellers Guild in Calcutta, who are also the custodians of the Kolkata Book Fair. So I MC the festival for 3 days, where we have about 25 events, and also help the organizers to get in writers from different parts of the country. I think you know that we have 3 literature festivals in Calcutta. We have the ABJ Kolkata Literature Festival. We have Kalam, which is organized by Malavika Banerjee, and our festival, which is held at the Book Fair premises. That's been fun. I mean, we've done 5 years of this festival, and very lucky and very, very fortunate to meet writers across the spectrum, fiction, non-fiction, biographers, graphic novelists, and so on. And also to see a wonderful response in a world where we say that reading is not as popular as it used to be when we were young. But when I see people buying books and getting their books signed by writers, queuing up to attend an event, it's very heartening and it's very encouraging. The other thing that we do in Ahava is, I never wanted to walk away from the youth and from children. So what sort of work that I was doing at Oxford, we had several clubs at Oxford Bookstore, like a literary club, we had a design club, we had a photography club, we had an IT club, we had an Oxford book lovers club, and so on. So I still work with the youth, we still work with the youth, but we are working with about 10 schools in Calcutta right now. We have different programs for them. The program that we run is called Books in Beyond. The whole idea is to encourage children to read beyond textbooks. It's a challenge, believe me. But when we go to a school and we conduct a particular workshop, even if I see 5 readers, I'm happy. You know, when I see they are responding to authors, they are excited, their vocabulary is excellent, they are participating, they are engaged. It's very, very, very encouraging. So we've been doing this for the last 3.5 to 4 years, and principals have been very cooperative and very kind to call us back for these workshops. These workshops are from class 3 to class 6, though I've done 7 as well. We have a similar workshop in Bengali to encourage reading in the vernacular. And we also have a heritage walk where we are tied up with Calcutta Walks, where, because today's students really don't have the time or the inclination to know the city's history. So these walks are for 3 hours where they're taken to different localities in the city, like Central Calcutta, Bow Barracks, you know, Dalhousie Square, and so on, to let them know, to connect them to the history of Kolkata. And we have a photography workshop for indoor and outdoor, which is conducted by the national award-winning individual called Shomu Shankar Ghoshal, and he's done numerous workshops with us. And we curate festivals and events, which is, I'll give you an example, like called Sitara, where we had 54 speakers and 6 events on empowerment of women. But we decided we were not going to talk about domestic violence or sex, you know, rape, blah, 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 what we read and hear every day. These events were very positive. They, you know, we wanted to do something where we wanted to show that women are moving ahead. They are surging ahead. They are doing different things in different walks of life. So this event was sponsored by Imami. Was held at the Calcutta Club. It's presented by the Merchant Chamber of Commerce, and Telegraph was on board. So then we did a very big children's festival to you know, mark Shakespeare's 400th death anniversary, where we had 12 schools coming on board, and St. James walked away with the overall crowd. So this is what we're trying to do. We are trying to work with children, we are trying to work with writers, we are trying to work with artists. When I say artist, I don't mean just a painter, but anybody who creates is an artist, to my mind. So this is, and it's been a challenge, Calcutta being Calcutta, and we hope to spread our wings to other cities from next year. Let's see how far we can go, but it's been a huge learning experience. So thank you so much for your time and for listening to us. Thank you. Thank you so much.